Yo guys, what is up? It is Nick. We are going to be starting up Quantum Break today. I loaded up a game just to see audio, check audio real quick. Hopefully it should be good for this. I think I've got it where I need to have it. I didn't actually get to any combat or anything like that, so I don't know how the sound effects sound. But we're going to get into this. We are going to be on normal, a moderate challenge, the recommended setting for most players. We will be getting... Do I want to do hard? I don't know how I'm going to like this game. That's the issue. We're going to have the challenge with Dark Souls 3 next week. Yeah, let's go normal. Save game reset. Yeah. Hold to start new game. We'll hop on into this. The little amount that I played, I learned that the loading screens are pretty long. Pretty long. So be ready in this game for me to talk about random crap because I lose track of what's going on. Let me shut up because I think this is opening cutscene.
The number one killer is time. It destroys us all. This is what you need to know. Time broke. A growing fracture leading to the end of time. We went after a device that could fix it. Things turned ugly. Pulse Stream was there to stop us. He has superpowers.
Jack.
Him and me both. We failed.
Jack.
And of course, time travel was involved.
Jack.
Going too fast for you? Okay. What do you want to cover first? You tell me.
Let's start at the beginning. When you first arrived at Riverport University.
I came back home to see my best friend, Paul Serene. He wanted to show me what he'd been working on. My brother Will was a scientist. He was also involved. Paul said it was world-changing. He was right.
Whoa!
Come on! Watch where you're going, man! Fuck off!
Get out of the road! Asshole. Riverport University. Here we are.
Hey. Thanks for the ride.
No problem.
You'd been away for 6 years.
Paul and I had kept in touch, but, well, not so much.
How did it make you feel?
I was just happy to see Paul.
Okay, there are these...
Paul.
Jack.
I just got to the campus. Where are you?
God, it's good to hear your voice. When you hit the courtyard, look right, you'll see this fancy modern physics building with the lights on. I'll meet you inside there. I am so looking forward.
Still haven't told me what this is.
I know. See you soon.
Why 4 a.m.? Why not wait till morning? Paul had always been a showman. Hey, do you know where the physics building is?
You mean the big-ass metallic turtle behind me? Hard to miss, man.
Thanks.
Alright, so there's like these different,
Hey.
There's these different items all over. I knew where the first one is, but I guess you can look around for them all, and it'll help you create a timeline, because obviously this game has to do with time. And so it will help you keep a timeline, I guess, of different events and where you are. That's all. That's what I get so far.
Protests seem like a lost cause. Maybe sympathize with the students.
Alright, we're not going to be too rushing through this game. We're not going to be taking a whole lot of time because obviously we have a week to get the majority of this game beat. But I am going to take a little bit of more time here at the beginning, get to figure out what stuff is. So this is another narrative object found. The heck is this supposed to do for me?
it's an ocean.
He's been gone for 5 years.
Dark matter and dark energy constitute over 95% of our universe. We're just a speck of light floating in an endless ocean of darkness. Every story finds its writer. He smiles and looks at his face. He lies with blood on his face, eyes staring.
What am I watching?
That lies beneath in the dark.
Is that it? Okay, we're not watching all of those. Because that's going to take forever. So this is another, looks like a timeline object, or a narrative object, yep. Let's go ahead and talk to this girl.
If you're with that fraternity, you've done enough damage. We're being shut down.
Hey, I come in peace. I'm just meeting a friend nearby.
At 4 a.m.?
Yeah, tell me about it.
Well, we're spreading awareness about Monarch Solutions, so if you want to know how badly they're giving us the shaft, then you could just ask me.
How do I ask you?
All right, what's going on here?
Okay. How would you feel if you knew a corporate monopoly was taking a massive dump all over your personal history?
That's quite an opener.
Good. Because that beautiful library over there is over 100 years old. It's part of the city's heritage. And Monarch Solutions plans to tear it down tomorrow. Do you want to know why? We've got a chart with all the details.
Didn't I already look at that chart?
Go ahead, check out the chart.
Okay,
Monarch's tearing down the library to build another research facility. And for what?
I bet you're gonna tell me.
To push their corporate agenda. I mean, look at those numbers. They're slowly taking over the city and everybody's completely blind to it.
It doesn't look good. Hey, I gotta meet my friend, but you keep fighting this, okay?
All right. Enjoy your booty call.
Not exactly.
All right, so I'm gonna get a lot of story. This is kind of important, so I know exactly what's going on. I haven't done, like, any research for this game, to know what the heck is going on. Like, when I get Dark Souls 3, I'll know what's going on because people have had it for, like, 3 weeks, so. In this,
Paul
though,
I've been hungry for success. Driven. He made it onto a lot of those top young professionals lists. And now he was coordinating some huge project at the university. It's a big deal for him.
Hey, protest's over. At home.
Not why I'm here, Chief. Holster that safety whistle.
Prick.
Wait, I can continue to talk to him?
Where's your uniform?
Excuse me.
Come on. I've been in shit enough to smell at security.
You sure this is somewhere that you want to be sniffing around?
Was that supposed to be a threat? Because that's adorable.
Just walk away.
I agree with him. That was a pretty weak threat.
Liam Burke, a Monarch security officer. Our first meeting was cordial compared to him introducing a rifle butt to my head later on.
Okay, so he's met him before. see here.
Not exactly modest, are we, Paul?
Back out. Okay, here's another Dr. Kim Memorial article. You guys can pause and read those if you want to. I'm not gonna sit here and read to you, because that's gonna be half of the game.
You made a long trip just to see a research project?
Well, reading between the lines, Paul was under a lot of pressure. He needed a friend. I wanted to help him any way I could.
Son of a bitch.
Jack Joyce. In the flesh.
The esteemed Mr. Paul Serene. I'm shaking money bags.
Shut up and bring it in. Welcome home. Six years. And I was starting to think you'd never come back.
Yeah, me too.
Come on.
Okay, looks
this way.
Looks like another
in the project lab. How was the flight?
First class. Thank you for that. It's a step up from our van trip to Utah.
I missed that van.
I'm guessing that Will's not meeting us.
He doesn't know we're here.
I knew Paul had asked my brother Will to consult on his project. Will was all the family I had, but he was difficult.
Incident? Jesus, Will. You do this time.
Okay, I'm trying to get this lined up for you guys, if you want to pause and read.
You think you got enough space here?
Well, you know, us business types need somewhere to practice our putting.
Okay, you can go in. No, I can't go in. Okay. The glass is kind of hard to differentiate. Think we're good. Let's go over here. Nope.
Jack. Going up.
It's quite the facility you got here.
What can I say? I have a knack of milking money out of wealthy investors.
Wow, that's not a... Here we go. Here's one.
Protests against Monarch are going strong, I see.
Yeah, I'm kind of surprised you didn't join in. I thought that kind of trouble was your forte.
Well, it used to be our forte. You're the one that sold out.
Oh, I don't know. Rich and successful isn't too bad. You should give it a try.
There's more to this than you're letting on. Is it about my brother?
Still worry about him, huh?
If Will did something wrong, then...
Jack, man. Look, I've been tight-lipped about this for a reason. This project we've been working on is going to change the entire world.
Why do I smell one of your long-winded presentations on the horizon?
I would never.
Oh, look. A perfectly placed presentation to illustrate the project. Now, who put that there?
Oh, shocking.
Okay. Enough joking. The lab's this way, Jack. Come on.
The city had changed. Paul changed. Didn't feel right being back.
It was your hometown. In 6 years, you never felt any desire to return?
There was always more keeping me away.
Come on, Jack. I am about to blow your mind.
We'll get to your lab. I want to see your presentation. I know you love this stuff. Come on, man. Dazzle me.
Well, if you insist. Progress. Our primary drive is a species. Over time, we have cured life-threatening illnesses. Explore the world.
Oh, good. Going into marketing spiel mode.
Don't ruin my flow. But there is one element which denies us true progress. Time itself. Now, I'm not a scientist, but here's how it's being explained to me. We've known that, in theory, a rotating black hole creates a deformation in space-time, potentially allowing travel through both space and time. Years ago, William Joyce, your brother, posited the existence of chronon particles, now known as Meyer-Joyce particles, which fill an all-encompassing field, enabling the constant and steady progression of time. Here at Project Promenade, we have combined both these theories to discover a way to manipulate that field. And the results are staggering. There's more, but that's enough of a primer for now.
All right, let's do this. So this is about quantum physics. Paul, you know my brother spent years stuck down that rabbit hole. Is that why you brought Will on as a consultant?
When Dr. Kim passed away, your brother was the obvious choice to bring in to replace him.
Okay, I'm just gonna take a quick look around here. Make sure I don't miss anything. I wanna check out everything here and at least the opening episode. Who knows what if we'll continue looking at everything or if I'll stop. I don't know. I haven't decided yet. Probably gonna look up IGN's review and just see how long the game takes so I can get a general idea on how long.
Welcome to Project Promenade.
So I can get an idea of how many episodes this will be.
Oh shit. You guys must have some budget. What is all this?
The future, Jack. You are looking at the biggest discovery of our time.
It's impressive, but Will's the scientist. What do you need me for?
There's a reason we're doing this at 4 a.m., Jack. I need someone I can trust. I need you to help me convince Will.
Yeah, I had a hunch.
When your brother found out the scope of what we were building here, he... Well, you know Will.
Yeah.
Hang on, I gotta get something from my desk. Will overreacted, scared off the investors, ranting about miscalculations, dangers, all with no evidence. It works, but they're gonna cut our funding if I don't prove it. I see the concept of personal space is still foreign to you.
Hey, somebody's gotta keep tabs on you.
Alright, there's 11 out of the 16 narrative objects.
Jack, you know asking for our help is not easy for me. I am in deep trouble. You see, the tests I have to run here are not, strictly speaking, legal. You're the only one I can trust to help me with this.
Whatever Will did, I want to make it right.
I love my older brother, but he didn't make it easy.
It's already essentially set up. Anyone can do it, but you're the one I want to do this with. Jack, thank you. I knew I could count on you.
Okay, so we've got, is this a text or an email? It's an email. Oh, this is a lot of reading. Holy crap. This is the longest email chain ever. Why am I read? I wonder how many people actually are like read all that. Like, I go to college all day. Like, the last thing I want to do is come home and read, man. It sounds horrible. That's like,
so, what's this?
Corridor schematics. Travel clockwise leads to a forward progression in time. Counterclockwise, travel backwards.
Oh, it's like you invented a clock.
Yes, years ahead of our time.
Okay, any more
narrative? I need you to push the lever over there, labeled Chronon Conduit. That'll activate the core. I'm going to run diagnostics and make sure it remains stable.
Okay, that's what I need to hit. Let me check around here for any narrative objects. Doesn't look like it so far. I'm happy I didn't play this, trying to find some combat, because, well, as you can see, we, don't have any combat. Okay, so I need to move the left stick. That's kind of cool.
That's just the Chronon Conduit initiating.
Keep going.
Are you sure it's supposed to do that?
Stable.
What was that?
The core replicates the effects of a rotating micro black hole, so activating it can be a bit intense.
A black hole? What exactly are we testing here?
You're about to find out. This way, we've got to raise the corridor. Just like old times, eh? Slightly illegal, moderately reckless.
I'd raised some hell with Paul in the past. I could tell this was different. Still, I didn't understand how massive and far-reaching the consequences for this would be. How could I? I knew Paul. He played it cool, but I could tell he was nervous.
It's happening. We're really doing this, Jack. It's gonna be amazing.
Ah, so...
Take this. You need this key to activate the corridor.
It won't let me pick it up. What the hell? There we go.
We need to turn the keys at the same time to activate. Security precautions. Ready?
It's like we're launching a nuke. Wait, we're not launching a nuke, right?
One way to find out. 3, 2, 1...
I wasn't ready to hit a...
God damn, Paul. What is this?
The corridor. The passenger enters one end, travels around the loop, exits the other, and arrives at the predetermined time in the physical location where the machine is situated in that time.
Passenger? Wait. This is a corridor for... You're actually going inside that thing? In the machine, through time. This is a fucking time machine.
I'm going to be the first, Jack. And you're my witness.
This is crazy, Paul. And this can't be safe. What happens when...
Our team has already proved it works in the trial phase. It is ready. We've passed every test, every inspection. We're about to make history, Jack. All you have to do is hit that switch.
Two minutes to the past.
Remember this moment.
What the hell?
Paul, what? How?
It's fine. It's okay. Stay calm, Jack.
Stay calm. There's two of you. You just fucking multiplied.
This is exactly what was supposed to happen. He's me, a future version of me from 2 minutes in the future. Your evil future self. We did it. Fucking incredible. I mean, just imagine the implications. We could warn people about disasters before they
disasters
happen.
Before they happen.
Cure diseases before they spread. I just had this conversation. Still sounds good second time.
Jesus Christ.
Now go into the machine. You need to complete the cycle. Yeah. Yes. Of course.
Wait, Paul. What are you doing?
It's all a big loop, Jack. I need to enter the machine and travel back to the moment I exited the machine in order to, well, be here.
And what if you don't?
There is no what if. I'm here. It's already happened. You saw it, Jack. We did it.
Oh, that's impossible. That's literally impossible. I mean, I can't even...
There's no time to stop now. We need to test the other direction. Set the machine to 5 minutes to the future.
What are you doing?
Oh, no.
Jack. Will? You have to help me with this. We have to shut this thing down now.
No. Stop him!
Shut up!
Hold on. The core.
Hold on. We can't shut it down. Paul's still in there.
Will!
Shut up!
Look at me.
Look at me! Put the gun down and we can talk, okay?
No, there's no time.
You're not thinking straight. Put the gun down! Jesus Christ, Will.
Time is going to end. Jack, you have to trust me.
For what?
Stop him!
No, I gotta let you out.
Oh, God. Oh, No.
No.
You okay?
I think so. I'll find a way out. Make sure Will's okay.
Yeah. Okay.
What the hell?
I could hear Will's words in my head. Time is going to end.
What the fuck is this?
Hey,
bro.
Ty.
Where the hell is Will? Hopefully we can get to some combat here because...
Is this really happening?
Depending on the difficulty of combat, I may restart on hard and just catch up to where we were and see and go from
there.
What
the hell? This is crazy. Will. Will.
She was right. All this time. I warned Paul. This could all have been avoided. We're too late.
Get Paul out of the machine. Wait, how do I get him out of the machine?
Stutter. Collapsed.
Jack! There's no other way out. I'm going through the machine.
Paul, wait. No!
Jack! This way! Jack! Huh? Jack!
Can we not run? Can we move? Let's go.
You can escape through the hatch I came in through.
I didn't want to leave Paul, but there was no way to help him. I didn't know where he'd end up.
Jack, in here. Hurry.
He's here. Fire.
What the hell?
Hurry.
Let's go. Let's move. What the hell? There we go. I was hoping we would get Will's gun there and get in a little bit of combat, but I guess not.
Jack, your hands.
Gotta keep moving.
No!
Jack, you just... What just... Go.
This way.
Move.
That was the first time my power started to manifest. An out-of-control burst of energy that saved Will.
Jack, your proximity to the pulse, it must have altered your relation to the chrono.
Will, what I just did back there, what the hell is happening?
That's what I'm telling you.
Not in the right language.
Explosion make time go bad. If time is an egg, then that egg is fucking broken. The time egg is fucked.
What? Why is there an egg in this?
There's a fracture in time. It's breaking down, leading to the end of time and door.
What?
Locked. They cut my security clearance. That didn't help.
Stand back. I'll get it open.
HQ, securing the
Will,
server room. Over.
More of them. Hide.
They're coming. In here.
I warned Paul about this. About the calculations. I tried to make you listen to me.
By shoving a gun in my face?
Yes, a gun. The universal symbol for shut the fuck up and listen to me.
Sound logic is always...
Shh, you...
Side. We sure he didn't head back up to the lab? He could have gone back and tried to tip the service.
This doesn't make any sense. How? Why are you even here?
That's your biggest concern right now?
Backup's en route to flush him out.
Paul brought me here to clean up your mess.
My mess? Do you even... You have no context for any of this, Jack. You weren't here. A lot happens in 6 years. This is bigger than us. Can't make it personal.
They're trying to kill us, Will. It's pretty goddamn personal.
Listen, getting you involved is the last thing I wanted. I'm sorry.
Right.
Alright guys, we are going to take a break here, call it an episode, and we will come back in the next one and continue our Let's Play of Quantum Break. So I hope you guys enjoyed the first episode. Drop a like if you did, subscribe if you haven't, and I will catch you all in the next part. Peace out.